ZorinOS 16 was already one of my choices for distributions to look out for in 2021. They always do something interesting with every major upgrade, and it looks like ZorinOS 16 is no exception. The Zorin team announced the availability of ZorinOS 16 beta with all the new features that come with it. It is based on Ubuntu 20.04 LTS. This is Ankush from It's First, and here I will be mentioning the key highlights of this release. First, the user interface refresh. The most exciting part of this release is the UI overhaul that gives it an impressive look. ZorinOS 15 was already a gorgeous Linux distribution, and with ZorinOS 16, they have refreshed the user interface to look nicer and cleaner. It looks like we might have a good-looking alternative to deepen Linux after all. The animations and the theme have been polished to look cleaner, especially with the new default background. It blends in pretty nice. In fact, it is a dynamic wallpaper that changes based on the time of the day. Also, the lock screen now displays your wallpaper blurred. Next, the addition of FlatHub. The adoption of Flatpack is increasing every day. Now, ZorinOS 16 enables the FlatHub repository by default, so you can easily find Flatpack apps right from the software store. Of course, you also have Snap Store enabled by default, hence the software store presents you a range of catalogs now. The welcome tour has also improved. This is quite common for every distribution to include. However, this time, ZorinOS has updated the tour to guide the user through the basics along with the customization options in a better and cleaner manner. This is definitely going to be very helpful for a newbie. Now, coming to the new touchpad gestures. Even though I stick to my desktop, for users with laptops, the new touchpad gestures should help you navigate quickly between workspaces and activity overview. Not to forget, the addition of a new sound recorder app makes it more interesting. The new sound recorder app is a minimal and beautiful app to let you record audio or speech. Having an audio recorder out of the box is a plus. Not many distributions offer it. ZorinOS 15 was moderately customizable. With ZorinOS 16, you get enhanced customization options for the taskbar and the overall layout of the system. You can set the panel's transparency, display it on multiple monitors, auto hide, and more. For the appearance, you can now select an icon theme, change the app theme, fonts, and more. The options also look much cleaner and easier to find. There's also a Windows 10x-like desktop layout planned. They plan it to introduce for users comfortable with touchpad, touchscreens, and mice. This isn't included with the beta release, but it is expected to arrive before the final release. ZorinOS was already a good choice as a Windows-like distribution anyway. In addition to all these key highlights, there are other improvements under the hood as well, such as a new jelly animation effect when moving Windows and minimizing it. It's maybe groundbreaking or just for fun. Addition of fractional scaling support for high-res displays, improved fingerprint reader support, unread icons and badges, the settings app refreshed with a cleaner and nicer look, and they have also disabled the built-in tracking and telemetry in Firefox app. Not to forget, it includes Linux kernel 5.8. Do note that this is a beta release and you shouldn't try it on a production environment if you're not sure about it. But to test it out, you can grab the ISO from the download link I've mentioned in the description box down below. So, what do you think about ZorinOS 16? Excited about the UI changes? What do you like the most about it here? Let me know down in the comments below.